while working around the clock, desperately using every tool at their disposal to give warning and save lives, it's almost unimaginable that forecasters tracking Hurricane Dorian would also be in the midst of a political storm. By now, we're all familiar with the infamous tweet by President Trump indicating Alabama would be hit by the hurricane much harder than anticipated, and the chaos that ensued. The National Weather Service office in Birmingham, Alabama, tweeted a correction to its panicked residents indicating they were not at risk. Days later, the president used a drawn-on, outdated map to prove he was right about the forecast, followed by even more tweets with more than week-old spaghetti models, all leading up to the National Oceanographic and Atmospheric Association issuing an official statement discrediting the tweet by the National Weather Service in Birmingham that had contradicted the president. This all happened as Hurricane Dorian was killing dozens of people, and it left meteorologists across the nation slack-jawed in disbelief that life-saving information was being distorted in the name of political appearances. Let's cut through this madness and get to the science of this hurricane. The National Hurricane Center, National Weather Service, and their parent administration, NOAA, did an exceptional job forecasting this hurricane. Do you think that over 200 years ago, when NOAA was originally formed, we would have had any idea that Dorian was coming, let alone that it would stall over the Bahamas and turn north rather than plow into Florida? No way! Think back to the lives lost during the Galveston Hurricane of 1900 or the Okeechobee Hurricane of 1928. 100 years ago, practically every major hurricane that hit the U.S. killed thousands of people. The fact that we have massive supercomputers constantly crunching data from all over the world to give us hints at what might happen 2 weeks from now is astounding. And it's all thanks to scientists at NOAA working for decades to try and save lives. Trust is the vital component of forecasts that ensures people take the appropriate actions to keep themselves and their families safe. If that trust is eroded due to political posturing, how can meteorologists save lives?